Hey, what's going on, ladies and gentlemen? My name is Rage, and we are back today to take a look at Odin's confirmed kit now that this information has been circulated on the Marvel Strikeforce blog post. But as well, if you guys haven't taken a look, it's pretty insane, guys, because I love the fact that they're adding a unique aspect to what they're going to be doing Odin. And at the same time, he is going to feel very much like a mythic character because of what they've done and the utility. He's going to have value in all game modes. And remember, this is going to be gated behind Dark Dimension 8, where you will be required to upgrade your characters to Isolate Purple level 3. We don't know about the gear tiers yet. It may just be presumed to bring certain characters to said levels because it just may be that difficult. And as we've seen from this kit here, I do believe that's likely going to be the case here because of how notable and meta changing is. But yeah, in case you guys haven't gotten a chance to take a look through it, I highly recommend you read through it. We're going to skim and go through some of the key details of what he's bringing to the table. I really like this paragraph that they added because it's a really good summary. So when the mythic Odin arrives, he's going to be the new Apex character. He's a blaster and he boasts massive health, damage, and focus stats befitting the Allfather. He also introduces a new dynamic to the battlefield. His special ability, Odin Sleep, not only removes exposure and exhaust, the very first character in the game to do so, but he also grants the 5 charges that gives him additional protection from negative effects. It boosts speed, damage, and resistance. And at the same time, when his charge is finally depleted, he's going to instantly generate ability energy, so that way, boom, next turn he can use his massive ultimate ability, which is another strong ability in itself. His true power, though, does lie in his battlefield effect, which is the Allfather's Fury. He activates this with basically his basic or a special ability, and then it allows him to clear all existing battlefield effects and activates his own, unleashing a devastating chain of attacks that pierces enemies, steal health, and clear negative effects from himself and allies, as well as bypassing defense up and avoiding counterattacks. It doesn't add in here, but he also can't be manipulated by speed. He's gonna be one of the first characters that also does not get impacted by trauma and as well as the other buffs, so it makes him pretty much untouchable. But we haven't seen this yet, guys, because it's his kit is very befitting of a god, and I am curious if they're going to be doing this more in the future, because is this going to be kind of the new trend in terms of them shifting over to these more focused on their stats? Well, his kit is good, and plus the revised stats are very good too. So you can see, just as an overview, he's going to be a hero cosmic mystic blaster Asgardian mythic character. So quite a mouthful there, but I do suspect he's going to have some really good synergy with Asgardians here. It doesn't have a lot of callouts to Asgardian, but if you slot him into the Mystic team for raids, he may very well be the reason that can put you over, especially once you have him unlocked. So what is going to be happening with his basic and special, in case you guys are a little confused by that verbiage? Well, it's called Gunnir's Onslaught right here, right? He's attacking all enemies for piercing, and as well, every time he does, there's gonna be drain, there's gonna be clearing of positive effects, and he also steals HP from all enemies and redistributes to himself. This additionally bypasses the heal block and redistributes a maximum of HP per target. So there is gonna be a maximum threshold, thankfully, but this is gonna be a very, very powerful component in Dark Dimension, because in Dark Dimension, those enemies you were usually up against have higher HP pools. So it's gonna be pretty cool to see how this character does scale very well with that. He also clears negative effects from himself and allies with his basic, which is pretty unbelievable. His basic already does a lot. He clears battlefield effects from the enemy side, and as well applying that battlefield effect, which is the Allfather's Fury. What is the Allfather's Fury? Well, once it's active on the enemy side, so keep in mind, abilities like Mephisto's mark and as well as the Nova's battlefield effect that he provides for his allies, this is going to get cleared right away whenever he does do an attack. So you can see on enemy turn, if this is active, Odin's going to be using his basic and then attacking them. When forced to attack as well, he does do less damage to his allies, so we know for a fact that he's overall just not going to be a really good character to control the attack, just because he's going to be reduced ally damage and as well focused on enemies with that retaliation. His special Odin Sleep He gains 5 charges up to a maximum of 5 times. So this is where he's going to be getting the charges, right? And remember, when he loses it, he can actually unleash his ultimate. He clears exposure from this character. He clears exhaust from himself and all allies. And he also flips negatives into positives. So really turning all any disadvantage you have on your team against you. He also additionally heals with his ability and up to for 50% of his max HP, and as well giving them offense up, defense up, speed up, and immunity. So almost doing a little bit of everything, honestly. There's also a barrier for himself and Asgardian ally. So this is that Asgardian call out that you can get a little bit of value from. But otherwise, if he's already used his basic ability, he's going to once again clear the battlefield effect on the enemy side. And then again, he's going to be applying that battlefield effect, All Father's Fury, to the enemy. So once again, pretty devastating, guys. His basic ability is going to be used constantly because he also has that assist mechanic similar to Old Man Logan. And obviously with his basic and that battlefield effect, it's going to be very devastating. Now, again, remember, once he loses all charges, he's going to be getting the 10 energy. So that's where he can use his Odin Force ultimate ability. He clears all barrier from enemies. He attacks all enemies for piercing damage and flipping all positives into negatives. He applies a heal block, disruption, and a blind for all enemies. That's crazy. We haven't seen this yet. I think I can't remember the last time we had like a mass AoE blind character, to be honest. He steals 10% from all enemies, redistributes to himself, and also additionally bypasses the heal block and death proof. So pretty devastating, guys. It redistributes a maximum 20% of this character's max HP per target. So once again, they just set a max threshold so it's not overpowered. But regardless, it's gonna be very, very insane. Characters killed by this attack also can't be revived. So think about, like, you know, very similar to Vow, where she redistributes, but at the same time, this is going to do more damage and also flips everything. So almost kind of like Icarus's ultimate right before it hits. And ignores defense up, is unavoidable, can't be blocked, can't be counterattacked. A truly worthy of ultimate ability fitting of the god and deity status that he holds. And last but not least, guys, his All-Father passive. So he can't be revived, obviously. He's way too broken to be revivable. And so I'm glad they at least kept that in. And again, to keep it fair and reasonable. On ally turn, he gains assist now. So very similar to Old Man Logan's mechanic. Gore would counter this assist mechanic, but he can't counter the battlefield effect, right? That's a different mechanic entirely. On enemy turn, he loses a charge down to a minimum of 1. And as well, on his turn, he loses a charge. So what that means is that, obviously there's going to be a few turns, but you're up against more enemies that have higher speed than Odin. It means he can probably get off his ultimate faster. Just something food for thought there. When this character does lose his last charge, he's going to be generating 10 ultimate ability energy, and boom, that's when he's going to be ready to go here for his ultimate. And, when he does stun, he does clear that as well. So very similar to what we've seen with Doom and the other Dr. Doom and the other mythic characters. We see that while charged, he gains 100% speed. So when he does get the charges after using his special, he's basically going to get an instant turn, because that's going to give him, 200 plus speed, which is faster than any character in the game. So the speed of this character can only be reduced by slow. This character can have speed bar reduced, gain 25% reduction, and as well as resistance. While charged, he's also going to have more reduction and resistance. And then right here, guys, this character cannot gain minor defense up, safeguard, or trauma. So he is effectively untouchable, ladies and gentlemen. But that's why he's going to be a very, very important member of the team for any team. And 100% he's coming into Arena once I can get him unlocked. But Dark Dimension 8 is going to be interesting, guys. I think we're at that very interesting situation where if you're a newer player starting out, or maybe you're a player that have started in the last year, you may very well unlock this character before Mephisto because of the ISOE Purple Constraint starting recently, as opposed to the Crimson Gear, right? So it's going to be interesting to see how many folks actually get him versus Mephisto or both, right? But anyways, that's enough for now, guys. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Very interesting times. This is a truly befitting kit for a powerful god status character like Odin. I'm glad they did it right, because this is super exciting to read, and he is going to be an absolute meta changer. So thank you for your time as always, guys, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.